Brand new feature inside of Photoshop Camera RAW is the ability to automatically remove people, but keep watching for a couple of hidden tricks to make this work a lot better. Alright, so we have a new people removal tool inside of Camera RAW. So let's go into Camera RAW and we're going to choose Filter, Camera RAW, and we're going to go in here and launch it. Now, one of the things to bear in mind, this does not have to be the beta version of Photoshop. It's actually in the regular shipping version. But you do have to open up the technology preview in Camera RAW for it to work. To do that, go to the gear in the top corner, and then you're going to see technology previews. If you turn this on, this is going to enable this feature as well as the other feature, which is reflection removal. So this is kind of like the equivalent of a working beta inside of Camera RAW. So we click OK. Now, the way this tool works is it doesn't remove all the people in the photo. What it does is it tries to isolate the subject, which would be this person, from the distracting people in the background. Now, we're going to do it another example, more difficult example in a second. This one's fairly separated. These are out of focus, so it's pretty obvious. But let's see how well this works. So in order to make the tool work, we need to go under the eraser tool. When the eraser tool, which is known as the remove tool now, you want to make sure you're using the left tool and turn on use generative AI. Now, if we move down, you're going to see distraction removal, and then you'll see reflections, which I've already done a video on, and then people. So let's just click on the little play button on the people. What it does is it twirls it down and shows the overlay. Now, we can change the overlay color. If the red is difficult to see, you can make it something like a yellow or something easier. So that's kind of nice. But apart from that, it doesn't have any other options at the moment. Well, supposedly. There is one other option. You'll see these little erasers here are the different areas that have been detected. Looks like a little bit here in the background was detected. So we can select that. And if we don't want to remove it, just hit the delete button. And that will remove it and just isolate it to there. Sometimes you'll see that this will be on other people. Now, unlike the tool inside of Photoshop, we don't have the ability to paint or to add or change these masks. I imagine that's something that will probably come later in the future. This is probably why it's still in beta. Now, when we want to remove, all we do is just click the remove button, and it's going to remove the people. And we can see, yay. All right, that's worked well. Now, let's have a look at some more options. So I'm just going to cancel out of this, and we're going to go into another option here. So let's grab this photo, which is myself at the Brooklyn Bridge. And as you know, if you go anywhere, there's people. So this is a little more tricky because look, we've got a crowd of people behind me. We have a woman behind me and then we have me here. But look, there's a lot of overlap. So what if I want to keep myself here and get rid of everybody else? Well, let's have a look. Let's choose Filter, Camera RAW Filter. And let's go to the same way. Grab the eraser tool. Go down to people and just click that little arrow and now it selects all the people. So let's just hit the remove and see what happens here. Okay, has this ever happened to you? Sometimes you get another object will appear like this. This is definitely not what we want. Well, here's what we can do about that. If we go down to the show overlay, it's going to show the different pins. So what we can do is we can select this pin that didn't work. The other ones worked, you know, good enough. This one here, and now we can choose to regenerate by going to the generate button. And now it's going to regenerate just that one pin. And then this time we should get something that we like. And let's turn off the overlay. And then we can see that worked really nicely. So I hope you found this video useful. Let me know in the comments underneath. And if you want to know more about this and some of the other new features inside of Lightroom and Camera RAW, check out this video here. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.